I'm sure you're all wondering, now that I told you I'm about to graduate, what am I planning to do after graduation? Good question. Well, after I graduate, I wanted to continue going to school. I ask myself why every day. To obtain a graduate degree. I want to do this because ultimately, when I grow up, my goal is to be an environmental research scientist. I want to focus my research on issues of environmental justice, specifically on the impacts of environmental racism. So, what does this have to do with hope? This past year, I have been having a lot of meetings over lunch and coffee with various people who have jobs that I am interested in pursuing, in academia, in government labs. I always ask them two specific questions. Do you feel that in this position, you have a voice to make change? Do you have hope that this change will occur? I have heard many answers. I have seen many despondent faces respond with comments about the state of current politics and how that impacts environmental research, especially in governmental labs. I have heard how stagnant academic institutions are and how slow change occurs. However, despite these comments, I see in all of the people that I speak with a belief that things are getting better. I see that they have hope. Over the summer, I read a book about climate change, and a specific line from this book has stuck with me ever since I read it. This book is called This Changes Everything, written by an author named Naomi Klein. The quote is in reference to a survey from the Geophysical Union. The survey indicated, somewhere inside each of us dwells a belief that we are nothing but selfish, greedy, self-gratification machines. And if we are that, then what hope do we have of taking on the grand, often difficult, collective work that will be required to save ourselves in time? This, without a doubt, is neoliberalism's single most damaging legacy. The realizing of its bleak vision has isolated us from one another, that it became possible to convince us that we are not just incapable of self-preservation, but fundamentally not worth saving. As drastic as this belief is, I have heard it expressed countless times, that the planet will continue without humanity, and maybe it would be better that way, that human beings are nothing but an invasive species, killing the planet that nurtures us. I think at some point I may have even believed this myself, but I know this is so wrong. This belief is completely devoid of hope. A part of my journey in figuring out what I want to do with my life has been the journey of finding hope. The hope that I can dedicate my life to environmental justice and academic research, and that it will make a difference. The hope that when I spend years of my life publishing research on the effects of air pollution, government agencies will listen, will make policy, and someone, somewhere will breathe cleaner air. The hope that if I have children, they will live on a more just and more loving planet. They won't have conversations with their friends about climate change because everyone will have awoken and committed themselves to finding a solution. For me, the process of deciding what I want to do with my life has been inextricably linked to learning to believe that what I do, whatever I do, will matter. The hope that we can truly change this world. Furthermore, for me, the process of finding hope has been the process of finding love. For both myself and for all of humanity. If I don't love human beings, I can't fight for them. Like I learned from Naomi Klein, the first step is learning to believe that we are worth saving and we are worth fighting for. So how can we find this love for ourselves and for all of humanity? I found it by finding a deeply loving community. I found it through my friends, through my family, and by connecting with the earth. I feel hopeful when I dance with my roommates as we make oatmeal in the morning. I feel hopeful when I hug my mother and father after being apart for a few weeks. I feel hopeful when I garden. I feel hopeful when I learn about science. I feel hopeful when people who, too, want to see change. I have been reading a book called Emergent Strategy by Adrienne Marie Brown, which has been fundamental to my process of finding hope, and I would highly recommend it. Whenever I pick up the book, I always read a single quote before reading anything else. This quote is from a woman named Naima Penman, and is as follows. When Hurricane Katrina slammed into the Gulf Coast, almost everything lost its footing. Houses were detached from their foundations, trees and shrubbery were uprooted. Signposts and vehicles floated down the rivers that became of streets. But amidst the whipping winds and surging water, the oak tree held its ground. How? Instead of digging its roots deep and solitary into the earth, the oak tree grows its roots wide and interlocks with other oak trees in the surrounding area. And you can't bring down 100 oak trees beneath the soil. How do we survive the unnatural disasters of climate change, environmental injustice, over-policing, mass imprisonment, militarization, economic inequality, corporate globalization, displacement? We must connect in the underground. In this way, we shall survive. I know that no matter what I do with my life, as long as I have a loving community fighting alongside me, what I do will matter. I will maintain hope, and I will be able to see the change that we can create.